good lighting, yeah. Right, Aki Karimi at BBTV. I've got Lyndon King Arthur with me, fresh off a second round stoppage win over Joel McIntyre yesterday. Lyndon, firstly, I've just heard Pat off the record giving you a compliment. Does that shock you?
Does. First time in 72 fights, amateur and pro, he's giving me a compliment when I'm not even been here. So it must be getting there now.
And he actually gave you the compliment when you weren't even here, so I know it was legit. Good performance, Lyndon. I mean, you were the favourite going into the fight, but it's the way you do it as well, isn't it?
I won't take too much from it, because like I said a couple of interviews yesterday, like I should be doing that to, if I want to go where I want to go, I should be doing that to them kinds of opponents. A tough English champion, coming off two knockout wins, it's a good opponent, but again, like I said, I should be doing that to him. No disrespect to him, but I'm levels above that level, so it was just a good win for me.
Now, we're used to seeing your methodical jab, but it was good to see the right hand coming in there, and you threw it early, and you threw it with spite.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's a little change in your makeup, because normally you break him down a bit more, but you just went for it, didn't you, a bit more?
I knew he was open for the right hand, and I thinking about, since I knew I was fighting him, I was thinking about that shot doing that to him, what he did, and I kind of knew it, watching him, he just from what I've seen, I knew it. I would get him with that, and it worked straight away. So as soon as I hit him in the first round with it, I seen his eyes like change, like, oh, he's quick, or he hits pretty hard, or whatever. It gave me a look anyway, and it was like, oh, I'm going to get him again. And give me another minute, and I adjusted, and once the jab caught him a few more times, the right hand landed perfectly.
You know what I liked at the end? You know, I saw flashes of the Lyndon that used to be at like the small old shows, Middleton Arena, the finisher, the predatory finisher.
You were
accurate, you didn't waste any shots.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
Were you happy with the finish, the barrel? I know you put it on your Instagram, but you know.
No, I was happy. I was definitely happy with it. It's always good to get the finish, regardless of what fight you're in, whether it's your first fight or your last fight. It's always good to get the finish. It's always good for the crowd, so good for the teller, and it's good for my confidence in me as well. So. Especially, I don't think I was too sharp in my last performance, my last fight at Bolton Arena. So it was good for me.
Now, there was something that was picked up on one of the interviews, the post-fight interviews. I mean, back in the day, I would have got this information first, but now, you know, these other channels get it. It's all right, it's cool though, it's cool. There were whispers of you fighting Callum Smith, or there's something in the pipeline or whatever.
I was as shocked as you. Like, I just heard that there'd been an offer or something, so again, I'm looking into that, and I'm not... this is no disrespect to Callum or anything like that. He's a great fighter. I'm a fan of his work. Been a fan, watched him all my career, pro and amateur. So it's just, I'm in that division now, I'm in that league where, and this is the light heavyweight division's popping in boxing. And what am I supposed to do? Am I not supposed to say? Am I supposed to shy away from these kind of things? I'm not supposed to be going into that confident, and I will do. So.
I mean, I know you respect him. I know it's all respected when it comes to him as well. So, but you know, if it's on the table, you're saying you'd be up for it, because he's a great name and he's coming up to the light heavyweights.
Come on, man! What a great fight! A great fight that would be, probably be in Liverpool as well. What, imagine that for me.
That's
what I'm in boxing for. You know, the first yard fight, the second yard fight, all of it, regardless of win or loss, it's the yard fight. So going into big fights like that, that's what every fighter from the top to the bottom's in it for. So why not?
Fair enough. And just one last one. We're here now on the small old show.
Yeah.
You're repping your club, Collins and Austin for the show.
Yeah, man, I'd love to come see the young fighters, Maro, got Niall, Alan Masuels on, all the other boys that are fighting. It's good to come here sometimes, and that's where I started, so.
Well, good to see you here, mate, and I'll let you get on and chill. Enjoy the night, man. Nice one.